Hello, everyone, and welcome to the virtual college exploration for all New Jersey students. This is sponsored by the New Jersey Association for College Admission Counseling and Strive Scan. So thank you for joining us today. Just a few housekeeping announcements before we get started. You can use the Q&A button on your screen to type your questions to the presenter at any time. So feel free to drop them in there. Your camera and microphone are off, so the panelists can't see or hear you. This is just one of many different sessions happening, so be sure to check out the full virtual schedule at njacac.org/virtualfair. And this presentation is being recorded, so it will be available within about a week at that same website, njacac.org. So if you want to share that with any of your friends or your peers and make sure that they learn about High Point today, you can certainly do so. So I'm going to turn it over to Ryan.
Thank you so much. Hi, everybody. Welcome to the session. We're so glad that you're able to be here. I'm Ryan. I work with all the students in the South Jersey area for High Point University. So thank you so much again for coming to this session. With how High Point has been able to adapt to everything with the COVID has been fantastic, and we're very excited to be able to still have students on campus. So if you haven't already, please try to see if you can come and visit. We would love to be able to have you. Obviously, we know that things aren't able to happen like that right now. So at High Point University, the first thing that we always tell our students and the always thing that we try to focus on for our students is this slide right here. What we try to let our students know is that at High Point University, every student receives an extraordinary education in an inspiring environment with caring people. These caring people are here to make sure that you are the best person you possibly can be. And we're basically trying to show our students that over your 4 years, there is a development plan for you. It's never going to be all on you to figure out, or it's never going to be all on you to figure out if you're going to do something or how you're going to do it. HPU has a plan to help make sure your dreams can become a reality. So we work really heavily on our four pillars of academic success. So what do those mean? Really, these are the four promises HPU makes over your 4 years to show these are what you will accomplish over your time here at HPU. First is academic excellence, which is really putting a focus on your academics, making sure that you are part of and are learning from the best people in the world. Experiential learning, which is 25% of every class being hands-on in some way, shape, or form, making sure you're not just getting the information through a teacher or through a lecture, but also getting your hands-on component that can really help set you apart in your job in the future. 4 year development of life skills. That means we're going to help over your 4 years to make sure that you are well prepared for the outside world through your resume, internships, things of that nature, and then modeling values and building character, which we will definitely go over in a minute. So at HPU, we have over 70 different majors for our students. We have so many different opportunities for students to do anything that really that their heart desires when it comes to what they are going to study. So you can see undeclared being our number one major, undecided. So we don't have to have everything figured out when you're coming here at HPU. We want our students to feel comfortable in any different degree so that they know that they have made the right choice. Business, biology, exercise science, and psychology are the top five majors. But like I said, we have 70 majors at HPU, and we actually don't ask you to declare your major till the end of your sophomore year. So that means that you have from now until the end of your sophomore year to figure out exactly what is going to be the best, the very best major for you. And with those students that are undecided, we have a fantastic program to be able to help them figure out what they're going to do in the future. So that is our program called Project Discovery. It's basically like going through Baskin Robbins and trying all 38 flavors at the same time, but being able to do that with your major. So trying a psychology class or a business class or a biology class to find out exactly what major fits really well for you. So over your 4 years, you don't feel like you're settling or trying to do something that you're not going to like in the future. They do that through individual counseling with our student success coaches. We have student success coaches who are just counselors that help you bridge the gap between senior year of high school and freshman year of college. They are helping with classes, they help with clubs and activities, things of that nature, and help you find the major that is right for you. with the different state-of-the-art facilities that HBU has. This is one of them. This is our planetarium, our cult planetarium. This is a fantastic opportunity for students to actually be ingrained in what they will be using in the real world with the different degrees and opportunities that they get. We have a human biomechanics lab and physiology lab for our exercise science students and athletic training students. We have a cane conservatory, which is for our botany students and our herbology students who want to study plants. Our cult planetarium for our astrophysics and astrology students, and a news and radio broadcasting studio for our communication students. Every single degree has a different area on campus where it is more hands-on and more focused to the degree and to the career that you are choosing. And with those amazing classrooms, you need amazing faculty. It's just, it goes hand in hand. So what HBU wants our students to be able to have is one-on-one connections with these faculty. That means a 15-to-1 faculty to student ratio. It means that you know your faculty and the faculty know you. I was an HBU student. I graduated in 2014. My faculty knew me like the back of their hand. I had my parents knew my faculty. The faculty knew what I did well in my classroom and what I really needed to work on and what I struggled with. That is just because they have such an intimate relationship with our students. They're able to know you and be able to know you in the classroom and out of the classroom. That being because 100% of our classes are taught by professors. We don't have any TA or graduate students that teach at HBU. We want to make sure that you are getting the information from the source and from the best minds within your career. HBU also has a 4-year graduation guarantee. So that means that as long as you are listening to your student success coach, you're listening to your advisors, as well as talking to your teachers, you're guaranteed to graduate within that 4 years that you're here at HBU. Even if you're undecided or change your major, you'll still be on track to graduate in that 4 years. We also have now a tuition-free 5th-year master's program for our students. This means that if you do your 4 years here at HBU and you complete everything that you need to do, you will be guaranteed a 5th-year master's program, completely tuition-free, either in communication or business leadership, which is extremely, extremely exciting for our students. We mentioned our student success coaches, which are those guidance counselors that help bridge the gap between senior year of college and senior year of high school and freshman year of college, and then project discovery, of course. So, at HBU, we also want our students to get as much exposure to the outside world as they possibly can. As you can see in this picture, this is our new studio. This is where our students are actually able to not only record and announce, but actually be able to work on a full news program that is broadcasted to the local community. It's all about what's going on at HBU, sports, activities, any accolades that any group might have received on campus, they actually report and do journalistic work with that. But we do 25% of every single class at HPU will be hands-on in some way. We know that a lot of people don't learn very well from being lectured or reading in a book. I'm one of those people. I need to be able to have my hands on the actual work to be sure that I'm getting the most out of my experience. And it's just a better way for me to be able to learn. And we realize that. So we actually allow students to go into their major starting their freshman year and be able to have hands-on experiences in whatever degree they're looking to do. Your communications degree with wanting to be a journalist, well, you'll be learning how to be able to put a full journalistic package together. How do I edit the clips? How do I make sure the audio sounds good? How do I frame the camera properly so I don't look all wampus and cattywampus and weird on camera? We want to make sure our students know how to be able to do that and have experience doing that. So when you do go for an internship or a degree or a career after school, you'll be able to say, hey, I know for a fact what I'm doing is right, and this is how I've used it, and this is the different examples I can give you. We also want to make sure you have access to industry leaders. So in front of you, you see Byron Pitts. So Byron is a CBS and NBC correspondent. He actually worked on the presidential debate last week. He was corresponding for them and Fox News. He is a innovator in residence for HBU. What that means is he comes 4 to 5 times a year to HBU just so that they can learn from him, just so that they have somebody else within the field of journalism that is somebody they can reach out to and who's still doing it at the highest level. That's the main thing. We want you to get as much opportunity to talk to the people who are at that highest level. At HBU also has an internship guarantee. So if you've ever wanted to work with Byron Pitts or work as a CBS correspondent, or like one of our students work on the Today Show, we guarantee every student at HBU at least one internship while they're here. That means that they're able to do their 4 years, get their degree, and know for a fact that they will be able to receive some type of internship during their junior or senior year, which is impressive. That also works for undergraduate research. Our students have abilities to do undergraduate research starting their freshman year, which is pretty crazy to think that at 17 or 18 years old, you're going to be able to be exposed not only to brand new technologies, but you're doing cutting edge research that is being displayed and being presented in front of national conferences like some of our students have. We want to make sure that our students have as much exposure to what they will be doing in the real world as they possibly can. And we do that so that you have the ability to know where you can go. We want our students to always shoot for the stars and be able to work as hard and really have those huge aspirations to work with people like, on the top left, Mark Randolph, who is the co-founder of Netflix, who works with our communication and entrepreneurship students, or Sint Marshall, who's on the bottom left, who's the CEO of the Dallas Mavericks. She works with Mark Cuban every single day to be able to make sure that their multi-billion dollar company stays on track and continues to make money for those people that need it. As well as Steve Wozniak, everybody who knows of Apple knows of Steve Wozniak. He co-founded that company and now works with our students in the computer science department to help bridge the gap between what they're learning in the classroom and what is actually going on with the technological revolution here in the United States, which is phenomenal. What we really want you to do is be able to not only have the people in the classroom and your teachers who are going to teach you about these amazing, amazing subjects who might have been out of the loop or out of the game for a couple of years, and also pair it with somebody who's currently in your career and doing it at the highest level. That's what we want for our students. We also have a fantastic program called the HBU Give Back Program. So the HBU Give Back Program is a program that students really focus on community service and giving back to the local community. We had 110,000 hours of community service last year, which is an insane number, especially when you realize it doesn't take any community service hours for students to graduate here at HBU. You cannot have done any service, but instead, each one of our students is doing at least 200 hours of service every single year. We only have 5,000 students currently on campus. That means that all of our students have realized that too much is given, much is required, which is what we try to do with our character development here at HPU. Our students want to make sure that they are giving as much as they are receiving. We need to also want to show our students that the change in character development over your 4 years at HBU is something that's going to happen. We're not going to ask you to think in any certain way or any way that is different than what you want to do, but we also want to promote that growth. We know that you must be completely different than you were at the start of your freshman year in high school, and we want to continue that growth as you have in high school currently. And through that, we also work extremely hard for our students to realize what it's like to have those different development of life skills. So what does that mean? HPU is called the Premier Life Skills University because during our work here in the university, we want our students to realize, yes, it really is all up to you to find the career that you want. We're not going to tell you a certain career that you should have, but it's not going to be on you to find out how to get that job. So over your 4 years, as you can see in the slide in front of you, this is our steakhouse on campus. Students are able to go here every single week on your meal plan. It's completely free, but this is a learning lab for students to be able to actually go into a scenario like they would within a different job interview. I'll give an example. When I first applied for my first job after school, the hiring manager tried to slip me up and say, hey, let's go to lunch. Your interview's almost over. We should go to lunch and talk a little bit more. that doesn't mean that the interview was over. That means that the interview was just going to a different place. So High Point really helped me be able to figure out, okay, I know now how to carry myself at a restaurant. I know how to be able to talk professionally over a meal, as well as we try to talk to our students and teach our students how to have a conversation without your phone present or without being distracted. We want our students to feel comfortable in these different situations because we know that these will be different environments that you will have to kind of navigate throughout your 4 years and throughout your career after school. And that is just through the entire 4 years you're here at HPU. We want to make sure that students have different seminars on life skills and how do I save money from retirement? What is a 401k? What is an I-9? How do I fill out a W-2? What do all these numbers and letter combinations really mean? And how does it affect me? And how does it affect my career and my life moving forward? We try to teach that for our students so you aren't guessing about that. Public speaking, we help our students learn about public speaking every single day. So you'll actually, in every class, have some form of public speaking that you'll have to do while here at HPU. Doesn't mean you have to be comfortable with public speaking, because a lot of people aren't really comfortable with that aspect of their careers. But we want you to feel comfortable and confident when you speak. We want you to be able to stand up, give a presentation on any different idea that you might have, or if somebody like your boss calls on you to give a presentation or give updates on a certain project, we want you to feel comfortable and confident to say what you need to say and then be able to move on and feel confident that you were heard. Time management, obviously, you all have had to really adapt to the time management piece moving towards virtually learning for the last half of the year. We just want to continue that. At HPU, what we try to do for our students is show that time management is a skill that everybody should have. Everybody should learn how to kind of schedule their day out accordingly so that you feel comfortable and never feel stressed out that you don't have enough time to finish everything you have in the day. Presentation skills, like I was mentioning, presentations are big, but we just want our students to be able to feel comfortable with being able to talk and give a presentation so that you feel heard within your panel, as well as the different purposeful learning labs that we have at HPU. Like you can see in front of you, this is our BB&T boardroom, where students are able to actually present to a full board of Fortune 400 companies different ideas and different projects, as well as different business ideas that they could be fully funded here at HPU, which is just phenomenal. We had a student that received almost a $10,000 startup on his business and now has almost a multi-million dollar business just off of that seed money, which is phenomenal. At HPU, we also have one of the most beautiful campuses in the country. If you haven't had a chance to come and visit, I highly, highly, highly recommend you come and visit. It is an absolutely phenomenal university, and it's a beautiful place to be able to work. We get to have tours for, 7 days a week from 8 o'clock in the morning till 4 o'clock in the afternoon. Obviously, with COVID, we've had to switch that because now we do single individual family tours. So every student who comes and visits, tours are limited, but we would love for you to be able to come. And we also have fantastic opportunities for virtual presentations as well as virtual tours on our website at www.highpoint.edu. On this amazing, beautiful campus, we also have a very vibrant student life. Like I mentioned, we have 5,000 students currently at HPU. Students are coming from all 50 states and 37 different countries. So we have a very diverse group from geography, but also their socioeconomic backgrounds, their history. It's an amazingly diverse campus and a fantastic way to be able to learn about different cultures and about different people. On that campus, we have 16 Division I sports. Lacrosse, basketball, and soccer for both men's and women's are our top sports, but volleyball for our women's has been something that has been an amazing, amazing sport for our students and has actually brought us to national championships multiple times, which is, I think, is the coolest thing ever, because I don't know about you guys, but I'm a huge fan of volleyball, so knowing that our team is that good is pretty fun. We also have 200 different clubs and activities for our students. That means that you will 100% find your family and your group of friends while you're here. We have everybody from DECA and student government, Habitat for Humanity, Key Club, different religious organizations on campus. We have a budding Hillel group. We have an amazing Islamic national group, as well as different Christian organizations on campus. But it means that everybody will have a place and have an opportunity to find friends at their university, which is what everybody wants. Everybody wants to feel included, and everybody is nervous about meeting people who are like-minded. We even have a group on campus that just meets on Friday nights and plays video games and watches movies instead of doing anything. It's just their time to be able to get together with their friends and do something fun. We have 7 fraternities and 7 sororities on campus. So if you're looking to do any Greek life is on campus at HPU. It's about 40% of our current student enrollment is Greek. Like I said, 7 fraternities and 7 sororities, and what they do is a rolling rush. So every semester, 2 weeks after the semester starts, they actually have a rush for both freshmen, sophomores, and I think juniors. You're able to do, basically they did this year a virtual rush, so be able to go to different virtual groups and meet other people and get to know their organizations that way. As well as club and intramural sports. So if you're interested in playing a sport but don't want to play at that D1 level, we have a club team which actually practice 3 to 4 times a week and plays on the weekends. Other schools goes to Duke, Carolina, Appalachian State. We even went all the way down to Georgia for a couple of our schools. So they have the ability to actually go and participate at other schools but have the flexibility to do other projects or do service work or possibly a fraternity or sorority while also still playing that sport. And then intramural is just a pickup game that people play every single week, and whoever shows up shows up. So at HPU, we have a few application deadlines coming up. At HPU, what we do for our application is only through the Common App. We have a Common App exclusive deal with them, so it makes it a whole lot easier for students to be able to apply through the Common App rather than going towards any other supplementary application. So we have early decision, early action, and regular decision for our students. So early decision is that binding contract. That is, High Point's my number one school. If I get into High Point, I'm only going to High Point. No questions asked, I'm all in. That's a big benefit because you're able to be learning first. You have the first notification day, which is November 23rd. You apply by the 1st of November and you hear back 3 weeks later, which is pretty amazing. With that, they get many priorities, which we will discuss in the next slide. But if students aren't able to make that commitment, we also have early action. So early action is our non-binding application deadline. You applied it by November 15th and you hear back by December 16th. But what this allows students is to apply early, apply for scholarships early, but have no strings attached, which is a pretty nice thing to have, especially this time of year. So for our students, I usually recommend either early decision or early action. And here's why. Early decision is an amazing option if students are able to have it. But I know that a lot of people aren't able to have the binding commitment or be able to go for that commitment right off the bat. So applying early action still allows you to have all of the benefits of scholarship, all of the benefits of knowing early before the end of the year, but it never has you having to make that financial commitment if you're not ready to make that commitment. The last thing I want as an admissions counselor is for you to feel like you are in any certain position that isn't comfortable for you and for your family. I usually tell students, I know that you can see regular decision down there, and I haven't mentioned it yet, but that's for good reason. The only reason I don't usually mention early action or regular decision for our students is because when early regular decision comes around, most of our scholarships have already passed, or most of our scholarships have started to run out. We don't want any students to not be able to apply for scholarship. And we don't want any of our students also to lose out on scholarship just because of the time that they apply. So whatever you decide to choose, that's the best route for you. I just usually push for early. I know I'm going to get this question, so I will definitely make sure that I mention, our application this year is going to look different because of COVID. We know that just because of just the sheer craziness, everything happened, as well as SATs and ACTs not being available for a lot of students, this has been a very stressful time. So at High Point, what we are allowing for our students is our GPA application is going to stay the same. We usually look for about a 3.3 GPA, about a 1260 SAT or a 26 ACT. This year though, due to COVID and due to the different standardized testing dates completely getting all muddled and crazy, we have allowed students to be completely test optional for all of our scholarships as well as our different fellowship programs that we have available. At HPU, each different program has a certain fellowship, which is just the honors program within that degree to be able to apply for after you've been accepted. Usually they have to include test scores and include standardized testing, but this year we are not going to look at any testing for any of our top scholarship or our fellowship degrees. Early decision has a lot of benefits. Like I mentioned before, they get the earliest notification date, which is November 23rd. They get priority in housing and priority in class time, which is an extremely big benefit. They also get priority in class schedule. So they get to figure out, oh, I don't want to take 8 o'clock classes. Well, they don't have to if they don't want to, which is a big benefit for a lot of students. And also they get a reserved parking space on campus. At HPU, parking is completely free. We have many parking spaces, and students, freshmen, are allowed to have cars on campus their freshman year. You don't have to pay anything extra. You just have to get your car registered with our departments just to make sure that you are being safe. We are ranked as one of the top safest campuses in the country for that reason. We just want to make sure our students from all over the world feel safe and feel secure while here on campus. And those are some of the huge takeaways that I want for our students to realize, that High Point is acting a little bit different than what most universities are when you look at how we are structuring the 4 years for the university. We want our students to know that academics, yes, they are going to be huge, but your academics aren't going to take you and be able to get you a job after school just on the fact that you completed your degree. You're also going to have to work on those interviewing skills. You're going to have to work on presentation and public speaking skills, as well as be able to have experience within your major at hands-on work that you've done to be able to show that you are the best candidate for that different job or for that different position. So we want our students to be able to have that over their 4 years, as well as be able to mentor you throughout that. What I loved about HPU and why I came back to work here is the fact that High Point really focuses on the success of their students. Not so that you have to be successful, you have to do this or have to do that. No, success is measured in a completely different ways for completely different people. I was a professional actor after school. My success was just being able to get a job, just be able to have a position where I was able to sing and perform. That was my way of being able to feel as though I was successful. So what we do at HPU is try to make sure that students realize that whatever you measure success is or success as, your admissions counselor, your mentors within your major, your student success coach, the career and professional development here at HPU are all geared towards making sure you feel as though you are the most successful as you possibly can be, just so that you feel comfortable and feel as though you really have gotten the most out of your 4 years here at HPU. We guarantee that four-year graduation. We want to make sure that it's known that students, if you are here and you are undecided, that's okay. You don't need to know exactly what you're going to be studying. You don't need to know exactly what's going on at the moment. You have plenty of time to be able to figure it out. And we are here to help in every step of the way, as well as we have that tuition-free master's program for communication and business students. We're going to watch a short video real quick. I'm going to mute myself, and then I will be able to jump on and be able to answer any of your questions. So make sure you're thinking of them during this video. Thank you.
Someone once said, "It's not what we say that defines us, but what we do." Could this have compelled Aristotle, Da Vinci, or Beethoven? Certainly Einstein and Mother Teresa were no bystanders. History's noblest and most anointed have distinguished themselves as doers, not onlookers. Now, there's you. Welcome.
Hi, I'm Steve Wozniak, the Woz, and I'm proud to be High Point University's Innovator in Residence. Welcome to High Point University.
I'm CNN's Wolf Blitzer. Welcome to High Point University.
Hi, I'm Mark Sanborn. I'm proud to be High Point University's Leadership Expert in Residence. Welcome to HPU.
Hi, I'm Seth Marshall, CEO of the Dallas Mavericks, and I am proud to be High Point University's Sports Executive in Residence. Welcome to HPU.
Hi, I'm Josh Groban. Welcome to High Point University.
Hi, I'm Byron Pitts, High Point University's Journalist in Residence. Welcome to HPU.
I'm Mark Randolph, and I'm proud to be the Entrepreneur in Residence at the premier life skills university, High Point University.
High Point University is first and foremost an institution of higher learning. Higher learning. But students and families are attracted here because we also invest in the idea of higher living. That's why we say, choose to be extraordinary. There's a growth mindset in our institutional DNA. So while our campus growth is impressive, the true relevance lies in how HPU creates an innovative learning environment that fosters the entrepreneurial spirit in the minds, in the hearts, and in the souls of our students. Do you know that life skills are what employers nationally list as a top qualification in their new hires? That's right. Every study shows that. Did you know that the number one reason new employees don't work out in their job is their lack of flexibility, their lack of coachability, their attitude, their drive, all of which define life skills? Parents spend a lifetime teaching their children values. And when they entrust them to us on the campus of High Point University, we have a duty, we have a responsibility to ensure that we are an extension of that, that we build on the values that parents have planted in the hearts of their children. You know, our gifted faculty and caring staff serve as heroes, as models, as mentors to our students, modeling the values of scholarship, of service, of generosity, personal initiative, joy, and so much more.
I remember on move-in day, pulling up to the line of cars to come in and looking at my mom and saying, "Mom, I get to stay here." And it was just that moment where it hits you. And I was so excited the whole weekend and the whole week. I'm still excited.
This is such a big list for us for at Prince Review for students. And then big one to watch here, we have an eye on this at Prince Review, is High Point. In our zone, I got that sunshine in my pocket. Got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body. It drops.
High Point University, Andy Grammer here. I'm coming to rock out on your campus. Don't miss it.
The foundation building liberal arts education is imperative in today's global marketplace. High Point University is committed to connecting that education to career-focused outcomes. Internships, an important part of the student's four-year career plan, provide valuable experience. HPU students acquire internships and establish careers at leading companies and organizations each year.
My name is Amy Stom. I'm a public affairs specialist at the Smithsonian National Air and Space Museum.
I'm Anthony Vita. I am a language strategy intern here at Maslansky & Partners.
I'm a digital media intern for Animal Planet.
This is a school that believes in the American dream. This is a school that believes the best days are ahead, and the leaders of tomorrow will propel our nation and our world forward.
You have my greatest respect and confidence as you seek your paths, as you go change the world, as we trust you with the future. You won't disappoint.
Be passionate about what you choose to do in life. Use your powers of reason. Cultivate humility. Remain optimistic and always try to serve others.
This is High Point University.
So like Dr. Cobain was saying on that video, we want our students to realize that this is your 4 years. This is a big investment. This is a big thing for you. And I think I speak for a lot of admissions counselors when I say that what we want for you is to feel confident. We want you to feel confident with yourself, with your choices, with your degree, with your choice of friends. We want you to feel comfortable and confident throughout your 4 years at whatever university and whatever institution you decide to go to. That's our main thing. We want you to be able to know over this next bit, and I'm sure you'll be having a lot of questions. And if you do have questions, please put them in the Q&A box. I'm here to, we're gonna have a little bit of a Q&A session after this. So be able to throw out any questions that you have about High Point, about applying to schools, things of that nature, put that in that Q&A. But we really want our students to see that if you come down to High Point, North Carolina, and you trust your 4 years with us, that over that 4 years, we're going to make sure that you are going to leave the most well-rounded person you possibly can be. And that's what we want. We think college should be. We think that you should be going in and trying to be the most well-rounded person you possibly can be. Next steps, if you haven't already, please think about coming and visiting our campus tour. If this sparks some interest, me talking to you has sparked some interest, we would love to be able to come and have you on campus. You'll be able to see our top five in the country dorms. We have one of the best campus visits experiences in America. It's one of the best tours I've ever received and ever given, honestly. So you're more than welcome to come down. We understand that right now it's not really viable for people to all come down and visit HPU. So we have plenty of virtual options, as well as a weekly Panther perspective every single Tuesday and Thursday. So what they do is kind of go and take a certain subject. Last week I talked about what is it like to go to a school from out of state and how do you kind of acclimate to that different opportunity. But they have different degrees and different subjects that they will take on each week for that Panther perspective. We also have virtual tours and virtual information sessions with yours truly. Every single, I'm doing them every other week. You'll receive an email from me to do one-on-one Q&A sessions with you and your parents and anybody that might have a question about college, FAFSA, scholarship, things of that nature. We also offer admissions interviews. So what I've been trying to do is more virtual opportunities to meet you face-to-face. I know that these are great sessions and the NJACAC, has done a phenomenal job with this college fair, but you also wanna be able to show your face and have somebody be able to talk directly to you. So if you have any questions, you're more than able to contact me. I work with all the students in the South Jersey area, as well as the students in Delaware, to help them with their college search process when it comes to HPU. That's my email, as well as my direct phone number if you have any questions or if you want to schedule a time to talk to me. Does anybody have any questions? If you do, please put them in the chat bar. I would love to be able to answer any questions you might have. I know we have the next 5 minutes to be able to we're right on time. About 5 or so minutes to be able to answer any questions about the Common App, about HPU, about anything. I won't say your name so you won't be called out too. I won't make that happen. Any questions? I see a question here. Oh, this is a great question. So the question is, what do you look for in a student? And that's a fantastic question. So what we look for in a student is a well-rounded individual. what we want our students to be able to be is just the same thing as what they would as who they are. We don't want anybody who is going to be just doing clubs and activities just to put on their resume. We want to see what you're dedicated to. We want to be able to see what clubs and activities you put your time and effort into. And if you haven't been able to do clubs because you have a job, you take care of your family, if you have just other interests outside of school, that's fine. We just want to see, where are you putting all of your time and effort in? What are you really trying to get out of your college and your high school experience? We also look for your essay in your Common App application. So that's the best way for us as admissions counselors, behind all of the numbers that we see with your transcript and your GPA and those test scores, we get to learn about you as a person through your essays and through your short answer questions. So make sure that you're really looking forward and really putting a lot of time and effort into just giving a little peek into who you are when it comes to that essay and those short answer questions. That's what I look for as an admissions counselor, is to be able to learn more about my students through their application, which is great. I have another question here of, what is the average application cost and what is the cost of tuition at HPU? That's a great question. So the application cost, actually, if any of you are that are here, email me and say that you were present at our NJACAC panel. I will give you a free application waiver to be able to waive your application for your price at HPU. So for you, it's not going to cost anything. But normally it's about $50 to be able to send in your application. And I don't remember what it is for College Board or the SAT to be able to send in your scores that way, but you're more than welcome to do that as well. At High Point, the cost of tuition is $52,000 a year, all included. That includes meal plan, your room and board, printing, parking on campus, all of our different D1 sporting events. You don't have to pay for any of those, as well as all of the different clubs and activities and different events that we have on campus are completely free for students. This question says, let me see if I can read it. Oh, okay. So this question is, how do I pick my roommate, or do we have an opportunity to choose our roommates freshman year? So at HPU, I'm glad that you mentioned that, because I did not go over our housing, which is a great catch. At housing, at High Point, we have the 5th ranked best housing in the country. It is beautiful, beautiful housing, and the housing is included with tuition, our tier 1 housing. Each time you go up a tier of housing for HPU is a different level of independence. So you keep going up, you might have a door to your own room. If you keep going up, it might be less roommates until you get to our top tier, which is basically having your own apartment. Not many people pick that option because everybody wants to have their roommates and be able to have that interaction with other people. But you're more than welcome to be able to do that. At HPU, we don't allow freshmen to choose their first roommates. Instead, we ask you to fill out a roommate survey through our Student Life Association. And what that survey actually allows you to do is scientifically match you with somebody who is exactly like you when it comes to a roommate. I call it match.com for roommates. You fill out a 40-question survey, you're able to pair with somebody who also stays up late or gets up early in the morning. Maybe somebody likes to have people over, or some people don't. We don't want to pair you with somebody that's going to cause friction. Instead, we want to start building your friend group the second that you step foot on campus. Your roommate's going to be the first person, and the different friends you bring in along just build your friend group out more and more, so that you're really starting off with a completely brand new group of friends right off the bat. I think I have time for maybe two more questions. Let me see, I answered that one. Diversity, that's a great question too. So at HPU, diversity is a huge, huge thing for our students. We wanna make sure our students feel comfortable and accepted while they're on campus. So we want to make sure that diversity is the biggest thing that High Point has been focusing on over the last couple of years. We have a fantastic diversity both through the 50 different countries that we all, or the 50 states and 37 different countries we offer for our students, but we also have a fantastic geographic diversity as well. This question said, I signed up for the SATs 5 times, but they got canceled. other than sending my score, but what if I'm unfortunate and cannot send my scores? That is completely fine. If you're not able to send in your scores this time, that is completely okay. For our top scholarships, even the top scholarships and full rides that we give out for our students will not be looking at test scores at all for that. If they have them, great. We'll be able to add it to your application and it's going to look phenomenal. But we're not going to make sure students aren't able to have that opportunity to get those scholarships just because they weren't able to take the test. It's been extremely difficult this year for anybody trying to take SATs or ACTs. And how involved is the student success coach with his or her students? This will be the last one because we're right on time. But for our student success coaches, you actually meet with them once a month. They're required to meet with them once a month, but you can meet with them every single day or every single week if you would like. The student success coach is going to be as involved with you as you want to be with them. They are going to help with making sure you're staying on task with grades, make sure that you're going to class, make sure that if you're starting to dip a little bit, maybe go over to some tutoring. Maybe you need to talk to your professor, but they get to meet with you once a month so that you're able to have those questions answered and so you have visibility with them. The last thing you want is for a professor or for a student success coach who's supposed to have your best interests at heart not know you at all. So they actually know their students extremely, extremely well.
All right. Awesome. Thank you so much, Ryan. And thank you all of our attendees for joining us today. So when you close this window, there'll be a link for a very quick 4-question survey, and we'd appreciate any feedback that you can provide for our awesome panelists today. Also, this, again, just was one of many sessions being hosted, so make sure you sign up for any additional sessions at njacac.org/virtualfair. And in about a week, you'll be able to find this recording as well as other recordings at njacac.org/virtualfair. Thank you so much for coming, and we'll see you later.